Hi, I'm Vincenzo Coya, and this is Stat545, the video series designed to help you write a clean and modern data analysis. Well, today we're going to go over five ways that you can use computer code to write a powerful data analysis. We'll be focusing on R, but these really apply to anything. Now, the first way you can code like a pro is to remember to save your code. So what this comes down to is the fact that running code is different from writing code. So when I first started with R, I opened up the R program that I thought was the only R program. And to my surprise, whenever I wrote code, I found that I couldn't actually go back and change the code. So what I didn't realize was that that R program was actually just the R console that was only intended for executing code, but not actually running code. So what I ended up doing is I ended up opening up Microsoft Word. I know Microsoft Word is not meant for writing code, but I did it anyway, and I wrote my code there. And then whenever I wanted to run my code, I copied it over into the console and ran it there. Now, this has the advantage that I'm able to actually save the code and rerun it again in the future. When you write your analysis in the form of code, it reads like a storybook. You know, you can read it from the top to the bottom, and you can sort of figure out what's happening. This is different compared to a point-and-click program, maybe something like Excel or SPSS, where when you open it up, you just see the results and you don't really know where you got those results from. So don't forget, the first step is to save your code. The second tip is to use an IDE when developing code. Now, an IDE just stands for Integrated Development Environment. And what that basically means is that you can both write code and execute code in the same program. Probably the best IDE for R is a program called RStudio. Let me tell you, discovering RStudio for me was a huge relief because now I didn't have to copy and paste from Microsoft Word into the R console. I could just write code in the upper panel and then execute it in the lower panel using a quick keystroke. Not only that, but an IDE usually has many other goodies that come with it. For example, it'll highlight your code with different colors so that you can read it more easily, and it'll even anticipate what code you're writing and will help you complete the code more easily. Give it a try, I'm sure you'll love it. Don't forget to use an IDE when developing your code. Now, the third tip is to get your analysis results by applying functions to your data. Now, this is where programming for data analysis differs from programming in general. So programming for data analysis, we take our data and turn it into an object that our programming language can understand, and then we apply functions to it so that we can get the results we want, like graphs, tables, and models. Now, how a function actually works depends on the programming language. In R, whenever you apply a function to an object, it'll give you something different, but it won't change the object itself. The original object will remain unchanged. It's up to you to actually store the output of the function in a new variable if you want to keep it. As I like to say, whatever happens in a function stays in a function. The fourth way you can use computer code to write a data analysis like a pro is to start with a clean slate. Now, what this really means is that if we want any hope of being able to reliably obtain reproducible results, we have to obtain the same results by running the code from the top to the bottom, not by running the code in some other order. Now, this might seem obvious, but think about it. When we're writing code, we usually don't run it from the top to bottom. We write code interactively. And because of this, as we're writing interactive code, we might end up seeing different results as we're writing the code. So what's the solution? The best way to get around this is to every once in a while just rerun your code from the top to the bottom. Or, better yet, just close the program altogether and reopen it with a clean, fresh slate. So the fifth and final tip is to use add-on packages to expand functionality. What this comes down to is the fact that your specific analysis is probably going to need you to run functions that R just doesn't have. But luckily for you, chances are somebody's already been in that same situation and has written that function for you to use freely. So what people do is they write similar functions and bundle them together into what R calls a package, and then they make that package freely available for you to use. Now, installing a package is usually pretty easy. It usually only requires you to run the code install.packages. And once you do that, the package you install is a proud resident of your computer for good. That means you only have to run that command once, which means it probably shouldn't live with the rest of your code. But installing the package isn't enough. Once you install the package, you need to tell R every single time when you want to use the functions that come with that package. You can do that using the library function. And since you have to do this every time, it's best to put it right at the top of your script so that every time you run the script from the top to bottom, that package is loaded and you're free to use the functions that come with it. So there you have it. 5 tips to help you use computer code to write a very powerful data analysis. 1. Save your code. 2. Use an IDE when developing code. 3. Get results by applying functions to your data. 4. Start with a clean slate. And 5. Use add-on packages to expand functionality. Join us next class where we talk about Git and GitHub to help you work more collaboratively with your peers and to help you version your work. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel by clicking the red button down below.